Hey friends, do you know just how easy it is to simplify the management of your Apache Kafka event infrastructure? Lena Hall is here to show us how you can use Azure Event Hubs behind the scenes to help you focus on your code instead of wasting time maintaining infrastructure. We're learning all about it today on Azure Friday. Hey friends, I'm Scott Hanselman. It's another episode of Azure Friday. I'm going to learn all about Apache Kafka and how to make things simpler with large-scale data processing. How are you, Lena?
Great. How are you, Scott?
I'm very well. Thank you for bringing me big data and lots of cool stuff with Azure Event Hubs. What do you have for me today?
Definitely. Yeah, I have here Apache Kafka. Mm-hmm. This is one of my favorite open source projects ever. This is really great because it allows us to ingest massive amounts of events and distribute it between publishers and subscribers really easily. It has a very rich community around it and so many libraries and connectors that we can use to get data from various sources. So one of the things that can get a little complicated is cluster management. Kafka can be deployed anywhere, on premises, in the cloud. And managing the cluster can become a full-time job.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
There are various configuration settings that you need to make sure are correct to ensure good performance, efficient cluster management, and sometimes when you add new topics or scale up the cluster, you need to do rebalancing and various operations.
So keeping it optimized and healthy is really important.
It is, and people spend a lot of time doing this,
okay,
in addition to programming applications for it. So there are some things that we can do to optimize it. Sometimes people switch to using managed services to do that, but in many cases, managed services require rewriting your application to target the new service. And sometimes companies don't want to do that, to depend on a new service where Kafka already has so many connectors and libraries.
If we're creating a huge amount of information, maybe it's coming from like what IoT hubs and little tiny devices. So I have millions of devices, like let's say I got millions of light bulbs. They're going to be sending this data and they don't care whether I'm ready for it or not, right?
Yes.
They just take that data.
Yes, it can be IoT devices, it can be financial applications, it can be any kind of input source.
Okay.
And Apache Kafka is great for aggregating it and distributing it between many consumers. So one of the things that we can do with Azure, and in particular Azure Event Hubs, is we can use our existing Kafka applications and clients and talk to Azure Event Hubs, and it will understand the Kafka language.
Okay, so is it pretending to be a Kafka ingress point?
It understands Kafka protocol.
It understands the protocol.
Yes.
Interesting.
So instead of talking to VMs behind the Kafka cluster that are called brokers, we are talking to a public IP endpoint of Event Hubs. And all that we need to do to change our solution is to change the connection information. We don't need to change any libraries that we use. We don't need to change any code, just configuration.
Interesting. So the things that I know how to use, the things that are already part of the Kafka ecosystem, continue to work.
Yes.
They are all speaking Kafka.
Yes, many of them are supported. Yeah. So I have a real world example that I can show. So let's switch to this. So very often, Kafka is used with Apache Spark. So Kafka can act as an event ingestion system and Spark as an event processing system. So here we have Kafka producer. As you said, it can be data coming in from sensors or it can be a financial application, anything. And there is a Kafka consumer that would receive data from the event log and process it in real time. So if we want to simplify our cluster management and use Azure Event Hubs with our Kafka producers and Kafka consumers, all that we will need to do is take a look at our connection configuration. So in Kafka, it's IP addresses of brokers, and in Azure Event Hubs, it's a public endpoint. And we can still use the connectors, like Apache Kafka connector for Spark, and just point our producers and consumers to the right endpoint. So let's take a look at how it looks like in action. So imagine a company is already using a Kafka cluster on Azure, HD Insight. This is my These are my broker VMs.
Okay.
And we have an Apache Spark cluster using Azure Databricks.
Okay.
So when we navigate to the Databricks cluster in Spark, we have a library attached for Spark streaming with Kafka. Mm-hmm. That's the only library we need. And this is the Kafka producer. So in real world, it can be sensors or any kind of information. And here we generate messages that are coming in every 10 second, every 10 messages every second.
Okay.
So, and we send it to Kafka brokers. What happens on the consuming end is we connect to those Bootstrap servers to our topic.
Right.
And perform our processing logic.
And is this Java I'm looking at, or is this a Kafka-specific
this
language?
This is Scala. So this is a good language to work with Spark. Mm-hmm. It's supported in Azure Databricks notebooks, and it's a really good interactive way of seeing how we can work with mm-hmm. events.
And you brought in a library with Maven, so everything thinks it's talking Kafka.
Exactly.
Because it is.
Because it is right now, yes. Okay. So we're receiving a lot of events coming in through our system.
Okay.
So now, if we want to switch to an Azure Event Hubs, we would need to create a Kafka-enabled Event Hubs namespace. And a namespace is equivalent to a cluster in Kafka, okay. except there's no cluster. It's just a container for topics.
Okay.
So we have a test topic here. We named it the same way as our Kafka topic. Mm-hmm. And we have the same, absolutely unchanged producer logic. The only thing that we change is configuration. Bootstrap servers now points to the public endpoint of our Event Hubs. Mm-hmm. And we're adding the connection string, which we can get from Azure portal settings and mm-hmm. shared access policies. Our processing logic is completely unchanged as well. Mm-hmm. So only thing we change is our connection configuration. And with completely unchanged processing logic, we're receiving same events through Azure Event Hubs using Kafka API. No change in libraries, no change in code, just change in configuration.
Does that mean that I would then no longer have to run Kafka for that? And then I don't have
yes.
to think about maintaining it, optimizing it, keeping it healthy and happy?
Yes. You're not running Kafka. You're using Kafka libraries, and you're running Azure Event Hubs on the back end.
Interesting. So I have a serverless, effectively serverless
yes.
ingress point for all of my Kafka messages.
Exactly. And that's very useful in a lot of cases where you don't want to take care of infrastructure management. Mm-hmm. One of the other benefits in this scenario is that we can combine and mix and match Kafka libraries and Event Hubs libraries. Mm-hmm. Because Event Hubs has such a good integration with Azure, mm-hmm. we can have our producers write to Event Hubs using Kafka APIs, but we can use Event Hubs APIs to talk with Azure Functions or Azure Storage and benefit from both of those systems.
Oh, I see. So once it's into this ecosystem, I really have the benefits of two ecosystems
yes.
that I can use. The Azure ecosystem of services that are available to me, as well as a number of the Kafka connectors, both in and out.
Exactly. Yes.
Very cool. Okay. Now, do people have this now? Is this in preview? Is this a checkbox?
This is available. You can try it out right now. Mm-hmm. There will be links under the video mm-hmm. that you can check it out. It's available.
Are there any downsides? Is there any reason why I wouldn't want to do this?
Sometimes you might not want to do this because you might want to run your Kafka cluster on premises in your own data center. Or you might want to manage all of the specific nuances of your broker configuration mm-hmm. And do a lot of fine-tuning. But with Event Hubs, you won't have to do any of the configuration except for planning for your throughput. Mm-hmm. And if in Kafka we would have to set up a lot of the configuration settings for this, in Event Hubs we have throughput units, which one throughput unit is basically for 1 megabyte ingress per second mm-hmm. or 1,000 events per second. And if you don't really have time to think about what your workload is going to be, you can rely on the auto-inflate feature, which will automatically adjust to spikes.
Excellent. That was my next question. And the fact that there's an auto-inflate is really good to know.
Yes, yes. It's very useful in practice.
Fantastic. All right. I am learning all about large-scale data processing with Azure Event Hubs for Apache Kafka. Thank you so much, Lena Hall.
Thank you.
I'm learning all this stuff today on Azure Friday.